Welcome to my YouTube channel FPGA Made Easy. On this channel, you will learn about the FPGA technology and programming from basic to advanced level. For more videos, subscribe this channel by pressing the subscribe button and follow us on our Facebook page for the notification. In this video, we will talk about the embedded system and how to implement an embedded system on FPGA. The second question we will address about what is the soft core processor and what are the types of soft core processors such as commercial soft core processors and open source soft core processor. In the end, we will discuss about what are the advantages and disadvantages of soft core processor for using in the development of embedded system. So let's start. Embedded system on FPGA. From the definition, an embedded system is a dedicated computer system in which hardware and software are combined to perform some specific task. But the recent advancement in the field programmable gate array technology, it is possible to implement the complete embedded system on the single FPGA chip. So the embedded system contain a processor for processing the data, memory for storage, I/O devices for receiving and sending information to and from the outside world. The fundamental component of any embedded system is a processor. Processors are classified into two categories. The one is the conventional processor, which are microprocessor or microcontroller, which are called hardcore processors. And the second type is called soft core processors. The complexity of integrated component inside the embedded system increased drastically, and it is not possible to design a processor for every single specific application. So it is a good idea to use a soft core processor having reconfigurable, predefined and pre-tested intellectual property cores. This is an alternative solution. The IP core or soft cores are designed using hardware descriptive languages such as Verilog or VHDL. By using these soft core processors in order to develop an embedded system on FPGA, we can achieve reduction in the overall cost and decrease in time to market. And these cores are realized to any FPGA from any vendor. So now we will discuss about types of soft core processors. Soft core processors are like microprocessors that can be adequately described for a specific application. The code of these soft core processors can be synthesized to different tools depending on the manufacturer. Soft core processors are provided by many companies, such as there are basically two categories of these soft core processors. First category is called commercial cores, and the second category is called open source cores. In commercial cores, there are few vendors like Altera, which provides Neos 2, Xilinx, which provides MicroBlaze and PicoBlaze microcontrollers, and Tensilica, which provides Extensa cores. Open source cores contain open source community which provide IP core component for the development of embedded system for both academic and research. Some examples include LeonSpark, OpenSpark and OpenRISC. In future videos, we will discuss each soft core processor in detail, and we will learn about how we can program and what are the different tools required to program these cores. Now, there are some advantages and disadvantages of using these soft core processors in order to develop an embedded system. So first we will discuss about some advantages. Flexible and easily customization for the specific application. We can change the soft core processor according to our application. It is technology independent, hence it can be synthesized and implemented on ASIC and as well as FPGA technology. Softcore processor architecture and behavior are described by HTL at higher level of abstractions, hence it is easily to understand by the designer. Peripherals in the processor can be changed. We can add or remove as per requirement very easily. In softcore processor, we have reduced obsolescence risk. There are few disadvantages of using softcore processor in embedded system, such as on an FPGA, the size and area is large for the design, which leads to higher power consumption, and the performance is lower than the conventional microprocessor or microcontrollers. Thank you for watching this video.